de la Yahweh, pa kun kakula a. Na do de la Yahweh, pa kun dubula a. Na do de la Yahweh, pa kun pokolola a. Na do de la, pa kun funya muli wunkole.
My guest on Studio Ken is journalist and women's rights activist Mtale Mwanza. Mtale, thank you for hosting us.
Thank you for coming, even though you disrupted my nail appointment. I should have been doing my nails, but yeah.
But it's for a good cause that you're here, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, well, you know, I like to accommodate people.
Thank you for accommodating us once more.
Yeah, so my nails are a mess because of Mr. Gondoy here. He insists I call him Kennedy, so yeah.
You claim to be a women's rights activist, but many women don't seem to agree with you. What are they missing?
I don't make any claims. I am who I am. I love to speak for women. I love to stand up for women's rights, and that's what it is. If other people don't agree, I have nothing to do with their opinions.
Why do you think they don't agree with you?
I don't know. Where are you getting these stats from, the statistics?
For instance, when you did your vagina rant on the breakfast show on Hot FM, so many women seem not to have agreed with you because of the way you went about it.
Okay, I think what made people uncomfortable is the fact that I used the word vagina on radio and not everything I said. I think that was a bit uncomfortable because there are children listening in the morning. So people felt like, oh my goodness, I was with my child in the morning and you just said the V word. So I think that's what the issue was.
Do you regret it?
No, I don't.
Why don't you?
Because I don't.
But people would still say that because of the word that you used, I mean, you offended some, like the children that you're referring to. And here you are claiming to be a women's rights activist without any regret for what you said.
Every part of the body has got a name, and...
But some names are sacred. You don't just say them anyhow publicly.
What is sacred about vagina? That's the word. That's what it's called.
Culturally, people may say that's not the right way to go about it.
Kennedy, I have no regrets. Next question.
And how about hanging or cutting the line when the Lusaka province minister called in?
I have no regrets.
Why did you have to do it?
Why not? He wasn't giving me a chance to ask him questions. So,
but as a journalist, there are other ways, other people would argue that you can conduct yourself other than the way you go about things. Is that your style? Is that the unique way that you've developed in dealing with your guests or your interviewees?
No. Like you said, there are ways of dealing with such issues, and perhaps that was the way that I deemed fit. So, yeah. That's what it is.
Tell me about your experience on the Red Hot Breakfast show on Hot FM.
Oh, the Red Hot Breakfast. Ah, man, the Red Hot Breakfast is hot. It's hot.
What has been your experience?
My experience has been... it's been a roller coaster. It's quite a hot show. The Chavulas have built a brand over the years with the Red Hot Breakfast, which is quite a strong brand. And that show is politically charged at times. It's a highly opinionated show. You need to be able to carry your own. You need to research. You need to read a lot. You need to have a thick skin. You need to understand and read times. It's different from anything I've ever done in my life. From radio on the Copper Belt in Flavor FM, going to Kumwesi, which was entertainment, Good Morning Africa, which was more entertainment lifestyle. The Red Hot Breakfast is just a different show.
What have been your lows and highs on the Red Hot Breakfast show?
Can I keep that to myself?
No, people want to know. People want to know.
I want to be able to keep a little... part of me.
I'm not going to allow you to do that. What have been your highs and lows?
Highs and lows. Listen, Kennedy, sometimes depending on the topic, you rub people the wrong way. Depending on what you say, you will find that people perhaps don't agree with you. And if your opinion is not popular, I mean, it could be something that I really believe in and something that I stand on. But if more people feel like that's not what... You know, the general feeling is sometimes I sit and I'm like, okay, maybe do I need to rethink my decision? Excuse me. Do I need to read more? Like, am I losing it somewhere? What am I missing? So it makes me read. Those moments for me.
But how about the accusations that sometimes would follow you? People accuse you of belonging to political party A, political party B.
But you see, that's the thing with that show.
Mm.
Of course, I speak based on truth. Mm. And that's what, you know, our bosses always tell us. You know, Kennedy, muchishinkata mwabo mwenso. If I call it as it is, depending on what the truth is, it may offend whoever is affected.
But don't you think sometimes you go overboard?
I don't think so. I'm called a cadre for both parties. One day I'm UPND.
But which party do you belong to?
One day I'm PF.
But which party do you belong to?
I will tell you after 2021.
After voting?
Yes.
Okay.
That one is my secret.
Is it really necessary to display your body in the manner that you do?
How do I do it?
Like you were in Siavonga. You were in your bikinis. And again, that caused a lot of talk.
When you go to the beach, what do? You swim, you're soaking in the sun, you're basking in the sun. I didn't go there to do anything else but to relax. So if I choose to swim, am I going to swim in a bubu?
But at the same time that you do all these things, isn't there a better way of doing it other than causing controversy?
Kennedy, how is a better way of swimming when you go on holiday? Please help me understand.
When
you go on holiday with your children, for instance, how do you want to, how do you swim?
My question is not restricted to you having to go to Siavonga to swim. Mm. I'm talking about generally.
But that's the example that you gave me. You said I was in Siavonga. Oh,
okay.
I was displaying my body, but I was swimming.
So you are saying that people are ignorant because...
I mean, if I'm going to a beach and I'm going to swim and somebody is saying I'm displaying my body, I find that offensive. I should be offended. Actually, people owe me an apology.
People owe you an apology?
Yes. Women should be respected and women should be respected based on their qualifications. And that's all it is. I don't know why you're also focusing on the word vagina.
No, I'm not focusing on it. I'm merely asking the questions that people have been wondering.
But it confuses me that I was attacked... And nobody worries about that.
But
everybody focuses on the fact that I use the word vagina. I find that very confusing. Don't you think even just your questions and everything is misplaced?
Who attacked you? Let's get to who attacked you.
Do you know why I said what I said on radio?
From the little that I can remember, mm-hmm. I think there was an event where people accused you of using your body to get the favors that they allege you did.
Not once, not twice, mm-hmm. not three times, more than that.
So,
and I decided to stand up for myself and I spoke and I said a lot of things because I work very hard. I have two jobs plus other running contracts. Okay, I make money. You know that I'm on radio. I leave this house at 04. This place is far. For me to go to Hot FM, I need to be there at 5:30. It's dark and it's cold, and I leave my son sleeping in bed. For me to be accused of everything that I'm accused of, I got tired of it because it starts to begin to affect my profession. So I decided to speak about it on radio. And from everything that I said, people focus on the word vagina, which is exactly what you're doing right now.
So why do people attack you? I think that's a question that should be answering. Why are you always being attacked?
It's not always, but for the fact that I do a politically charged show, there are times when I would say something that maybe doesn't sit well with someone somewhere. So people find the need to want to discredit me, but I'm not going to allow that.
I'm not here to discredit you.
The only way people want to discredit me, I do a show with two guys. There's never a time they're accused of going out with this person and that person because I'm a woman. Obviously, I'm the weaker sex. I get attacked the most, and I never really understood why. So that's what I was trying to bring out, to say, I do the show with two guys. Why are they not talked about? When they speak, they're not accused of A, B, C, and D. But as a woman, it's easier to attack a woman and just accuse me of sleeping with anyone. That's very offensive. It's offensive because I'm qualified for what I do.
Some of your attackers actually accuse you of sleeping around or being a prostitute. Are you?
That's very insulting. I'm not. And I'm actually shocked that you're in my house and you're asking me such a
question. No, I'm here asking
but
questions.
But I should be offended because, Kennedy, I've also seen some of your interviews. You've interviewed Miles before. You've interviewed Pilato before. I've never heard you ask them any of those questions. So why are you asking me that?
Different people will be asked different questions what people say about them.
So where do you get the idea that people say
you just go to your Facebook page, just at the weekend.
I've never seen a comment about me being a prostitute.
But just at the weekend, for instance, when you posted a picture, mm-hmm. someone commented and you responded with an insult.
They were commenting based on the fact that they're ignorant. I'm at a beach and I'm swimming. What am I supposed to wear? Can you tell me? If you were me and you've gone on a holiday,
it's not me
what
to
am
answer,
I supposed to wear?
It's not me to answer that question. But the fact is that you responded with an insult.
Like I said, you know, Ufontini wavantu nshaka pide mo.
Can't you be an independent and strong woman without causing controversy, like in the manner that you dressed?
Dressed when?
The manner that you dress.
When?
All the different times. The controversies that follow you, Mtale.
Listen, look, I don't, you need to tell me that on this particular day you wore this and it's a problem.
Doesn't it concern you though, that your life or your interviews, the way you conduct yourself, there's always going to be controversy somewhere?
But that's not my problem.
What do your parents make of the way people talk about you?
My mom prays for me. She's a very strong, staunch Catholic woman. And yeah, she prays for me.
And your dad?
My dad is late.
Would he have been comfortable with the daughter being called all sorts of names and the daughter getting the kind of pictures that we saw you take in Siyavonga, for instance?
I'm not sure, but let's be clear. In Siyavonga, I was swimming and I was at the beach, and you don't expect me to be in a suit or a bubu. What's the problem? And I don't know why you keep asking me that.
No, I keep on asking that question because I mean, over the weekend, it was a long weekend, and your pictures caused quite some talk. So it's not me asking you for the sake of asking you. It's about following what people were saying on social media.
Let's talk about what people are saying on social media.
The same questions that I'm asking you.
You're exposed. You've been out of the country. Don't people swim? Do you not see Angelina Jolie at the beach with her kids? But, is it because I'm black or because I'm a woman? Because we're in Africa, I should be attacked? People swim. It's life. You go to the beach, you wear a swimsuit or a bikini, and you swim. What's the problem? Why is everybody getting their knickers tied in a knot? I don't understand. The moment I'm going to swim, swimming, the fish sticker. You know what? Those are things that, those are for me, those are non-issues. The fish are concerned.